Hello everyone. So today I'm going to discuss about logical functions of MS Excel. Okay. So you know all what is the logical function. So logical function means it is a function which based on some condition. Okay. So there are different types of logical functions are there. So mainly the logical function is if, or, and, nested if. Okay. So I'm going to discuss the four functions here. Four logical functions here. If, or, and nested if. Okay, so this is my table. Here the marks are given here, English, Math, Science, then full marks is 300 and total marks is also given. So in my previous classes I have already discussed about how to find the total marks. So this is the formula of finding the total marks. I am using here the sum formula. Okay, so here I am using the first if statement. So if means it based on some condition. If that condition is true, then it will give some output, otherwise it will execute some other output. Okay, so in my if statement I am giving the cell S maths. Okay, I am giving the column maths. Okay, and my formula will be if the marks of maths is greater than 80, then it will display the letter L, means letter. Okay, if someone has someone got more than 80 marks in maths, then he will get the letter marks, otherwise no letter marks. Okay, so this is my condition. So I am using here if statement. So for this, first you have to write the formula here. So formula is equal if. So here see here, first one is logical test. Logical test means this is the condition. Okay, so here my logical test is maths. If maths mark is greater than 80, then what is the output? Output will be simple letter marks. So I am given here within double, see here, value if true. Okay, value if true means if this condition is true, then which value will be displayed, or else if this condition is false, then this value will be displayed. Okay, so value if true, if this condition is true means if someone get more than 80, then what is the value? Then I am giving here one letter. Double inverted comma. Here display as letter marks. Okay. Otherwise, if no value, someone get less than 80, then it will give you no, only zero. Okay. Then enter. See here zero. Has given here. Why zero? Because see here maths mark is 69. So he got how much? Zero. So I am filling all the columns. See here. See, second person got letter marks because here 96. So he got letter marks. So third one is 85. So letter again 80, but no letter because I have given here someone who will get greater than 80, not greater than equal to. That's why it will give you a zero. Okay, second person is also get zero because 58. So you just notice one thing, zero is displayed in the right hand side and L is displayed in the left hand side. Why? Because by default the integer, means the number, will be displayed as a right alignment and the text will be displayed as a left alignment. Okay, so that's why it is given this type of style. Okay, next one is, this is all about if statement. Okay, next one is or. So or means here two condition will be there. If this condition is true or another condition is true, okay, two condition will be given. If one of the condition is true, then the true value will be displayed, otherwise false value will be displayed. Okay, so here I am giving the formula. So my formula function will be, if someone get, here see, if someone get the total marks greater than 200, okay? If someone get the greater marks, means total marks greater than 200, or maths mark greater than 60, then he or she will get the grace mark. What is the my condition? If someone get the total mark greater than 200, or the maths mark greater than 60, then he or she will get the grace mark. This is my condition. Okay, so I am writing here the condition. Equal, so before writing the or statement, you have to mention the if, because or is associated with the if. So if, then first bracket, or. So logical one, logical two. Logical one means first condition and logical two means second condition. Okay, so my first condition will be, if the total marks greater than 200, and the second condition is if the maths mark, here it is displayed as a plus, but no plus, here should be comma. Okay, so maths mark greater than, how much I have said, 60, okay, then first bracket completed, okay, then my grade will be, within double inverted comma, it will be displayed as grace mark. Okay, he will get the grace mark. Otherwise, he will get zero. Means no grace. Okay, this is my condition. If or the total marks greater than 200, then, or if the maths mark greater than 60, then he will or she will get the grace mark. Otherwise, no grace mark. See here, first one got the grace mark. Why? Because he got the total mark greater than 200, and the maths mark is also greater than 60. So he got grace mark. So now I am giving all the value. See, all the student has grace mark because all the student has got greater than 200. Okay, but here see, this student has get greater than 58, but he also got the grace mark because my condition is two, either total marks greater than 200 or maths mark greater than 58. So one condition has matched, that's why he also got the grace mark. Okay, this is about or. Next one is AND statement, and in AND statement, both the condition should be true, then only true value will be given, otherwise false value will be displayed. Okay, so in AND statement, my condition is, if someone get the total marks greater than 280, if someone get the total marks greater than 280 and maths mark greater than 80, then only he will get the grade excellent, otherwise no. Okay, the two condition, both the condition should be true, should be matched. If the someone get a total mark greater than 280 and the maths mark greater than 80, then only he or she will get the excellent value. So my value will start now. My function equal, so this is also same, only the in case of means formula is same, you have to write the if statement, because within if statement you have to write the AND statement. because if is associated and is associated with the if. So if and okay, then my value, then my this one will start, condition will start. See, logical one is if total marks greater than 280, and second one is if maths mark greater than 80, then it will display the, it will display as the it will then it will display as what excellent. So excellent, okay, otherwise zero. So see here, first one is zero. Why? Because see here, total marks is not greater than 280, and maths is also not greater than 280. First one is also not maths, because 219, because and my formula will be the first one, the means total marks should be greater than 280. So the value is not maths, that's why. See here, all the values are zero, because no one has, all the marks is 280, less than 280. That's why it is given here zero. So I am changing the formula. My, say here, my value will be 260, okay? Then what is the result? So what is the result? Still everyone got the zero. No one get the excellent, because here, see here, to here 266, but maths mark is 58. That's why no excellent. Again here, 85 in maths mark, but 249 in total marks. So both the condition should be matched. So if I change something else, if I give here, I'm giving here say 200, okay, and no 200, say 220, then only I'm yes, one student has get excellent, because here see total mark is 249, this is greater than 220, and maths mark is greater than 85, so both the condition has matched, that's why excellent has displayed. Last one is nested if. So if one if statement is under the again another if statement, that is called the nested if statement. So my formula will be here, my function, my condition is if someone get total marks greater than 250, then it will display grade A. If total marks greater than 200, then B. If the total marks greater than 180, then C, otherwise D. Okay, 180, not 160. Okay, so my formula will start now. If total marks, okay, greater than how much? 250. Okay, then it will display it as grade A. Okay, it will display grade A. Next one, again another if statement. If the total marks greater than how much? 200. Then it will displayed as grade B. Okay. Then the third condition is again if the total mark is greater than how much? Total marks is greater than how much? Total marks I have taken here the first cell of the marks means 160, then it will give here how much? So how much it will give? C. Otherwise if don't, if you don't want to give any last one grade D, then who is grade less than 60 marks? Definitely this is grade D. Okay. So grade D. Okay, so I have to close all the bracket. Three brackets will be there. Okay, now enter. So it is displayed here, say C B. Okay, so now I am filling all the sheet. See here. So this has displayed B B B A A. Okay, because the total marks B is because 219. So this is B and A is 256. So 256 means A, 266 is A. So this one is your grade. So this is all about if, or, and nested if. Okay. So if you like my video, then like the video and subscribe my channel so that you can get all the latest notification and videos of mine. Okay. Thank you everyone.